If you know a little bit about me, you know I love Charles Spurgeon. His life, his struggles, and the testimony of his faith and commitment to Christ are a source of encouragement to me. I've also been reading his devotion morning by morning for decades, and one recently prompted this Live It theme, just so I could give credit where credit is due. Last week, I talked about humility and how it is a necessary characteristic of a true follower of Jesus. In this past Sunday's message at In Focus, I defined humility as an accurate assessment of our self-importance in relation to God and others. We covered an accurate assessment of our self-importance in relation to one another in the previous episode of Live It, so I won't do that again. But in relation to God, the assessment of our self-importance is the same. We are servants. Jesus said, "The Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve." Obviously, we're not greater than Jesus, and if you don't believe so, that is an entirely different discussion that I don't have time for. Subsequently, we then serve God and others with joy as servants. And on top of that, if we follow in Christ's footsteps as servants, we can expect difficulty in this life. Humility should characterize us again, because humility does not feel the right to better treatment than Jesus got. Jesus himself said in John 16:33, "In this world you will have trouble." I want to remind you where this tribulation comes from. And in order to do that, I need you to keep your head on a swivel. First, look upward. Maybe this is the most obvious, but we look at our Heavenly Father in order to behold what we are to become. If we are to be conformed, as Romans 8:29 says, we are to be conformed into the image of Christ. And if that's the case, we'll live more holy lives. How easy are you being conformed? The Bible says it takes refining, and that refining often happens in the furnace of affliction. Look downward. I think we too often forget we're in a spiritual battle, and our ancient foe is a daunting adversary. We were all a part of the kingdom of darkness before Jesus made us a part of the kingdom of God. And as Spurgeon puts it, no king will willingly lose his subjects. The one who has come to steal, kill, and destroy, who goes about like a roaring lion seeking whom he can devour, is at work in the earth today. He doesn't just give up trying to harm you. When we look downward, we can see where much tribulation comes from in this life. The enemy is always trying to hinder God's people. And if your faith journey is trouble-free, you may want to see if you're being conformed into Christ's image or if you're conforming Christ into yours. Look outward. There are many different aspects of this concept, but mainly understand this, that the world is not our home. We're strangers and aliens in this world, and it's not our final destination. We're going to encounter trials and tribulation in the world around us. People will hate us, speak evil about us, dislike us, lie about us, persecute us. And Jesus said that people would do that because they did it to him first. James tells us we can't be friends with the world and friends with God at the same time. Stands to reason, we will have trouble from many different kinds of foes in the world. And then lastly, look inward. This will be the greatest source of our trouble in this life, as it is the one that we're always having to fight. Spurgeon was quoted once as saying, "If any man thinks ill of you, do not be angry with him, for you're worse than he thinks you to be." We look inward at our own heart, our thoughts, our motives, and we observe what is there. Is there still a sense of selfishness, self-centeredness, self-preservation that prowls around the depths of our souls? Well, that is the trouble we have to deal with in this life. Sin from within is the greatest threat to human flourishing right now. Humility is the antidote. So humbly come before God and let him change you. Now, while this may seem overwhelming, the rest of John's scripture in John 16 says, "Take heart, for I've overcome the world." Take heart means to not move, to be deaf to threats, and to have a heart like iron. Whatever trouble we face, and it comes from up, down, around, and within, Jesus has won the victory, and his peace prevails. I want to encourage you to look back to where we started, upward, and you will see you are more loved than you ever dared hope. Let's lift our eyes up to Jesus. He will finish and perfect our faith. I hope that encourages you today.